Good evening. Okay, good evening, Jaime. Okay. Okay, good evening, students. We're gonna start with today's class, and we are going to continue with unit number one, right? This is the last class for this unit. So we're gonna wait a minute, a couple of minutes for the rest of the students. Then we are going to continue with this slide presentation. Okay. There we go. Okay, good evening. Good evening, Gabriela. How are you today?
I'm fine because it's Friday.
Okay, yeah, that's good. Amazing. Because today is Friday, right? So that's why. Okay, really good. Okay, good evening, Marlo. How are you today?
Hoy no puedo decir very good. ¿Cómo se dice cansado, teacher? Buenas noches. ¿Cómo, cómo?
Tired.
Tired.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Ah, pues así.
Sorry, so do I. Yo también, no se preocupe. Pero we're gonna try to do our best, right?
Teacher, question. aprovechando ahorita, question, teacher.
Yeah, tell me.
La otra semana va a haber clases.
No.
No.
No, no, we're going to have vacation.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Okay. But you're going to have vacation, but you have to stay at home, right? Okay, very good. Carlos Alfonso, how are you today?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Very good. Very good.
Okay, okay, nice. Good. I'm glad to hear that. Okay, let's see. Marvin, how are you? Good evening.
Good evening, teacher. I'm fine, thanks.
Okay. I'm really good. Thanks for asking.
Okay.
Okay. Carlos Enrique, good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Okay, okay, really good. Okay, Jaime Ernesto, are you there? Okay.
Hola.
Hello, good evening.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, how are you today, Jaime? Okay, okay, really good. Okay, students, remember to turn on the webcam, please. Enciendan la cámara web. No tengan miedo, pena, right? Okay, very good. We are about to start with today's class. So, let's get started with this.
¿Dónde está la cámara web? ¿Cuál es la cámara web?
Okay. Okay, we're gonna wait for Jaime, right? Okay, very good. Okay, that's good. Let me see. Okay, students, let's get started with today's class because of the time, right? And we're gonna start with a warm-up activity. Vamos a empezar con el calentamiento que hacemos diariamente. This is like a feedback. Esto básicamente es como una retroalimentación, right?
El audio.
The what we saw yesterday, right?
El video.
Okay. Okay,
no, acá. ¿Y la cámara? Tengo cámara.
No.
Pues sí, no tengo cámara. ¿Y la cámara? ¿Dónde pediste la cámara?
Es que no sé cómo ponerla.
Okay. I'm gonna wait for him, right?
Mira, pues. No hay cámara ahí.
Okay, it's ready to set the webcam. Okay, okay, students. Did you remember that yesterday's task we were talking about?
¿Dónde lo conectaste?
Bitcoin 2, right? Bitcoin 2. Bitcoin 2, right? What does it mean, Bitcoin 2? What is the meaning of this?
Vamos a.
Okay, vamos a, boy, a. Really good.
Uh-huh.
The class before yesterday's class was related to Ken, right? Ken. For information and possibility. Okay, really good. And after that, I mean, and before that, we were talking about have for obligation.
Have to.
Obligation, yeah. Have to, yes, really good. And the first class that we saw was related to count and non-count nouns, right? ¿Recuerdan de eso?
Yes. Right, teacher.
Okay, really good. Okay, Jaime Ernesto, good evening.
Hoy sí, hoy sí.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
hoy sí. Glad to see you.
¿Estoy bien ahí?
Yeah, yeah.
Teacher?
Yeah, really good.
Okay, okay.
Okay,
excellent.
Very nice.
Excellent, okay, hoy sí.
Okay. Basically, students, today class will be, va a ser un repaso de lo que vimos, las cuatro clases, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. What we're gonna do right now as a warm-up activity, you have to identify all of these topics, right? Tienen que identificar todos estos temas. ¿Cómo así? Let's see. An example. Tienen que utilizar una. Darme un ejemplo de cada uno de estos temas. For example. ¿Se recuerdan los que eran contables y los no contables, los nombres?
Yes.
Yes, sure. Okay, okay, very good. Tiene que utilizar una con have for obligation. Aquí sería una sentence. Y una sentence with can and una sentence with be going to. I'm going to start, right? Please pay attention to this. For example, with non-countable now, we got a sun. Sun.
Sun.
Or jam. Sun. Sun.
Arena?
Yeah, really good. Esa no se puede contar, right? No se puede contar. A menos que dediquemos toda nuestra vida a contar grain by grain. Okay, really good. Luego tenemos jam. Jam es una mermelada. Tampoco se puede contar. Ese es otro ejemplo. Y tengo a couple of examples using have to. For example, I have to explain useful information to you. With can, I can give it to you some example about the class, right? And the last one, I'm going to practice English. Yeah, really good. Okay, right now I'm gonna choose one of you and I'm going to point one of these topics and you have to add a sentence or a noun. Voy a seleccionar uno de esos topics, un nombre de ustedes, y ustedes me tienen que decir una oración utilizando cualquiera de estas temas que ya vimos, right? Okay, ready? Yeah, sure. Okay, Fabricio, good evening.
No.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you today?
I'm fine, teacher.
Okay, ya se asustó ahí, Fabricio. Ya me tocó a mí, pero no.
Y no sé qué es.
Okay, we're going to start with Marvin. Okay, Marvin, give me a sentence using this.
Have for obligation, and I have to tidy the desk.
Okay, can you repeat that again, please?
I have to tidy the desk.
Okay, okay, very good. Thank you, Marvin. Really good. Thank you so much. Okay, Carlos Herrera, you want to practice, right? Okay,
give okay, me teacher. I'm going to learn English this night.
Okay, very good. Nice. Okay, Carlos, René, really good work. Okay, here we go. We got the last one. Carlos Alfonso, give me a sentence using this.
It's can.
Yep.
I can. Excuse me.
Okay.
I can play football in the weekend.
Okay, okay, very good. Thank you, Carlos. Really good. You look like, you know, like the people who really like to play soccer, right? Okay, that's good. And we're going to continue with Gabriela. Gabriela, are you there?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, Gabriela, give me a noun that you can count.
Count. Book.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Book.
Okay, book, yeah, really good. Now, give me an example. Uncountable now.
Uncountable, rice, honey, use, water.
Okay, tea. Very good. Okay, nice. Congratulations, Gabriela. Really good work. Okay, Gabriela nos dio muchos ejemplos ahí. Okay, very good. Okay, good evening, Tatiana. How are you today?
Good evening.
How are you?
Fine.
Okay, Tatiana, can you give me an example about uncountable nouns? Uncountable nouns. Los nombres que son incontables.
salt, sugar.
Sugar, really good.
Low.
Okay. Okay, nice. Love, right? El amor no se puede contar, es inmenso, dice Tatiana. Really good. Okay, nice. Okay, very good. Okay, students, because of the time, se nos salvaron varios ahí. Vamos a continuar por el tiempo. Así que me encanta ver esas sonrisas. No, no. Y ahí se salieron con la suya, right? But we have to continue with today's class, right? Okay, let's see. Okay, here we go. We're going to continue. This is the last class for unit number one. La última clase de la unidad uno. Luego pasaríamos a la number two, right? Okay. The topic for today's class will be vocabulary and practice, right? Today we're going to practice the four topics that we were discussing during the week. Vamos a practicar los cuatro temas que vimos durante la semana. Okay. Keep in mind that practice makes perfect. La práctica hace el maestro, right? Okay, very good. Así que don't be shy. Solo por eso vamos a continuar ahí. Y Jorge, you ready right now?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, very good. Because yesterday you got a problem with your microphone, right?
Yes, I knew. New headset.
Ah, really? Nice. Cool. Okay, entonces estrenémoslo ahí, Jorge. Read the specific objective.
Okay. Lesson objective, specific. The participant will be able to ask and ask for information about countable and accountable noun. Have for obligation, can for possibility,
yeah.
Be going to.
Okay, really good. Thank you, Jorge. Really nice work. Okay, now Jaime Ernesto Hernandez, can you help me to read the class objective, please?
Okay, si me equivoco un poco, disculpe que es primer día.
Okay, don't worry.
Class objective, idea of the class.
Yeah.
Participating will be
able.
Know how to participate, vocabulary, learn during the week.
Really good. Thank you, Jaime. Really nice work. Okay, Jaime, welcome to our class. Don't worry if you make mistakes. No se preocupe si cometemos errores, eso es parte del aprendizaje. I am here for you, estoy aquí para ustedes, para explicarle, asking whatever you want about the class, and I'm going to try to give you the right answer, right? Okay, very good. Okay, students, continue with this. We got the attendance list, right? Okay, attendance list. Okay, vamos a pasarnos esto, la vamos a pasar en un momento. Okay, así que we're gonna have useful sentences during this class, right? Before to see this, se recuerdan que al principio me decían las oraciones, right? Luego aprendimos algunas palabras conectores, que algunos ya las sabían, que eran and, also, in addition, in my opinion, my experience, in my case, y sonaba un poquito más diferente cuando ustedes expresaban sus ideas, right? Eso es genial. Similar va a pasar con estas useful sentences, estas oraciones útiles que demuestran un punto de vista personal y un punto de vista general, right? Okay, let's get started with this. Let me see, Gabriela, can you help me to read the first one, please?
Personal point of view.
Yeah.
I be that strong.
Okay, okay.
La siguiente también.
Yeah, yeah.
I dare say that strong. Okay. I'm sure that strong.
Okay.
I have no doubt that strong. Okay. I strongly believe that strong.
Okay, okay, really good. Thank you, Gabriela. Okay, as you see, students, Gabriela really liked to participate. That's amazing. Thank you. This show an strong point of view, right? Eso nos demuestra un punto de vista muy fuerte y personal. ¿Cómo así? Veamos. What does it mean, I bet that? I bet that.
¿Apuesto qué?
Ajá, ¿cómo?
¿Apuesto qué?
Ok, really good. Apuesto que esto va a suceder así, right? Pueden utilizar el going to. I bet that I'm going to get a good job. Apuesto que voy a conseguir un buen trabajo, right? Okay, nice. Then we're going to continue with this. It says, I dare say that. I dare say that. What does it mean this?
Me atrevo a decir esto.
Okay, me atrevo a decir que. Y dicen lo que se atreven a decir. Teacher, I dare say that. Me atrevo a decir que esto no es así como usted dice, right? Y pues obviamente I'm gonna surprise like this and you have to give me an explanation, right? Si ustedes notan, chicos, todas estas puntos de vista muchas veces no los comprendemos y son los que se usan cuando American people are talking, right? Cuando las personas americanas están hablando y por eso decimos what he said, qué dijo esa persona, eso no me lo enseñaron en clase, and so on, right? Okay, así que I bet that, I dare say that, I'm sure that, I'm sure that.
Estoy seguro que.
Okay, really good. Estoy seguro que, for example, I'm sure that my students, all of you, going to learn how to speak English. Yeah, estoy segurísimo, right? Okay, good. Then we're gonna have this. I have no doubt that.
Yo no tengo duda que.
Okay, really good. Yo no tengo duda que esto va a pasar. Y dice la explicación, right? Todo esto es importante. All of this is really important. So that's why you can take note if you want. Pueden tomar nota de las que consideren que les pueden servir, right? Okay, screenshot, right? Yeah, sure. And the last one that we have, personal point of view, I strongly believe that. What does it mean?
Como que creo firmemente algo.
Okay, muy bien. Como yo firmemente creo que. Muy bien, really good. Thank you, Marvin. Ok, eso es cuando ya estamos seguros de algo. Tenemos pruebas. Tal vez tenemos fotos o algún documento firmado, right? Ok. Tomen notas si es importante para ustedes alguna de ellas. Now we're going to continue with the general point of view. Ok, Tatiana, are you there?
General point of view.
Yes.
Some people say that.
Really good.
Most people think. Believe that.
Yeah.
It is often say that.
Really good.
It is generally accepted that.
Yes.
Accepted.
Accepted? Yeah.
It is generally accepted that everybody knows that.
Yeah, really good. Thank you, Tatiana. Nice. Okay, students, when you want to give a general point of view, you can say this at the beginning of sentences, right? For example, the first one it says, some people say that. ¿Qué quiere decir esto? What does it mean in Spanish?
Algunas personas dicen que.
Okay, muy bien. Cuando les ha contado, right? Algunas personas dicen esto, teacher. Y lo que usted dice, no, right? No es así, es allá y todo lo demás. Y luego, pues, yo aprendo de ustedes. Okay, really good. Luego, aquí entramos en un dilema. Many and most. Many, ¿es contable o incontable?
Cuando vayas al apartamento, busca esto.
Contable.
Contable, muy bien. Many people think that. Muchas personas piensan que, esa, cuando usted está hablando de eso, son personas que usted ya conoce. Usted puede contabilizar. Ah, mis amigos piensan eso. Pero cuando usted dice, ojo acá, most people think that.
Mucha gente.
Mucha gente, yeah, really good, mucha gente. Acá sería la mayoría de las personas. Incontable, porque no estamos definiendo un number, right? Yeah. Y believe es, ustedes pueden cambiarlo por think. Think es creer, y believe es, I mean, think es pensar, y believe es creer, right? Okay. Bring it. Then we're going to have this. It is often said that. This one, you're going to say said. Said. Yeah? Como cuando están sedientos ahí. Teacher, tengo sed. Like this. It's often said that. Yeah. A menudo se dice que. A menudo se dice que. Okay, really good. Luego tenemos, it is generally accepted that. Generalmente se acepta que, lo que ustedes quieran decir, right? And the last one, everybody knows that.
Creo que ella programó una reunión con el consejo.
Todos saben que.
Okay, todo el mundo sabe que y lo que ustedes quieran expresar, right? Okay, ¿tomaron nota de las que les puedo hacer?
Ah, sí.
Yeah. You take notes already? Yes, really good, nice. Se van a acabar los cuadernos ahí conmigo, right? Okay, really good. Okay, let's continue with this. Me parece that we had a homework yesterday class. Did you remember homework? Or you are surprised like this? Yep. ¿Hicieron la tarea, chicos?
Yes.
Yeah, really good. Okay, nice. Okay, I don't know if you want to share with the rest of the class. ¿Quién quiere compartir su label con el resto de la clase? Ajá.
Buenas noches. Yo no he podido entrar a la plataforma.
Okay, good evening, Wendy. How are you today?
Aquí en el trabajo, pero aquí los estoy viendo.
Okay, okay, very nice. Don't worry. Okay, the homework. Ya comienza con la homework de ayer. Hicimos una chicken label. Okay. Como todos quieren participar, right? Voy a leer algunos cuantos para que nos dé el tiempo. Ok, veamos quiénes son los lucky students, los sortudos. Let me see. Ok, Fabricio.
La estoy buscando ahorita, teacher, no sé dónde la puse.
Okay. Estoy buscando en Wikipedia.
Ahí on Google Pictures. Ok, ready. Ok.
Puede empezar si quiere.
Yeah, go ahead.
Mientras. Yo lo escribí ahí, ¿verdad? Es from y from Industrias La Constancia. Okay. In Avenue Independence number 526 San Salvador.
Yes.
To Samsung Store in San Salvador.
Okay.
Tracking number WO 74
Yes.
25. 20 9 units. Chipman 12 31.
Yeah.
And date is 31 July 12.
Okay.
No, 20, eh?
Yeah.
2020.
20, yeah, 2020, really good. Okay, thank you, Carlos Alfonso. Congratulations, really good work. Okay, nice.
Okay.
Now we are going to continue with Fabrizio. Fabrizio, you get it, right? You got it, yes, really good.
Es que, es que sí la tengo, pero no recuerdo, creo que.
Okay. You got it, but you don't have it, right? Okay, that's good. Veamos, vamos a darle tiempo a Fabrizio. Okay, Marvin Ernesto, go ahead, Marvin.
Okay, sí. ¿Me oye, verdad?
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Business, top brand, products, perfume Chanel.
Yeah.
From Estados Unidos, Market Store, ¿quiere ver? 609 Castle Ridge, Austin, Texas. 78738.
Yes.
Made in France. 22 Avenue Marseille, 5501 Paris, Francia.
Okay.
Tracking number is 94059956 4363.
Okay.
Quantity 100 unit.
Okay.
Shipment 9B3.
Yes.
Sender CA8B.
Yes.
Date 31 July 2020.
Okay.
Sí.
Okay, really good, nice. Good job, Marvin. Congratulations, really good work. Okay, now we're gonna continue with Fabrizio. Okay, I'm just kidding, right? Okay, mientras Fabrizio busca the homework. A veces es normal que el gato se la haya llevado. I don't know what's happened with the cat, but cats are really, you know, lazy. Okay.
It's generally accepted.
Ya la tengo.
Okay, okay, you got it. Okay, Fabrizio.
Okay,
information. Okay, go ahead.
From Embotelladora La Cascada, S.A. 27 Street. Oriente, no me acuerdo cómo se dice.
Okay, okay.
Number 229 San Salvador, El Salvador. Telephone 2234 000. Fax 503-2225 H. Apartado sería el. y ahí sería from Massas USA Inc.
Yeah.
Number 192 Commerce Street. It's Haven City 05612.
Okay,
quantity
okay.
7100 units United States.
Okay, really good. Thank you, Fabrizio. Nice. Good work. Okay, very good. Okay, students, now I understand that you got how to make a chip label, right? At least you got the idea. Al menos ya tienen la idea de cómo a diseñar una shipping label, right? Eso es genial. Así que vamos a ir step by step, right? But right now we're gonna vamos a pasar lista. Okay, yeah, we have it here, right? Así que ready with your name, listo con su nombre. Veamos Jaime Ernesto Navarrete Navarrete.
Hernández Navarrete.
Okay, Hernández Navarrete, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Present. Ahí, presente, diga Jaime.
Ah, perdón, presente. Okay, no. Primera vez. Okay. De esta clase, por supuesto. Disculpe, okay. Por favor.
No, no problem, right? Okay, José Vladimir Jiménez Escobar. Okay. Okay, José Vladimir. I think he's not here yet. Carlos Enrique Martínez Genoves.
Presente, teacher.
Okay, really good. Let me see, Wendy Sarai.
Presente.
Yeah, really good, Wendy. Nice. Jose Angel Santos Martinez. Jose Angel is not there. Okay, Gabriela Zamora Orellana.
Present.
Okay, really good. Tengo problemas con su segundo nombre, Gabriela.
It's normal.
Okay, ¿cómo se dice?
Merari.
Merari, right. Okay, mm-hmm. That's good. Okay, José Alberto Ortiz Molina.
He's Jorge, teacher.
Jorge. Okay, I'm sorry, Jorge Alberto.
Present.
Okay, really good. Carlos Alfonso Alvarado Hernández.
Present.
Okay, good. And Fernando de Jesús Roldán Torres. Okay, Fernando got a meeting. Dice que tenía una reunión. Okay. Carlos Antonio Mejía Hernández. Okay, Carlos Antonio Mejía Hernández. No, wait. Okay, I'm sorry. Let me see. William Alexander Martínez Enríquez. William. All right. Okay, that's good. Let me see. Miguel Ángel Alexander López Crespín. No, not yet. Okay. Marlon Ernesto Rodríguez Sandoval.
Present, teacher, present.
Okay, okay, really good, Marlon.
Andaba trayendo las pupusas.
Ok, yeah, yeah, I noticed that. Me traba ahí las dos que le pedí, right? Yeah.
Ok.
Ok, good.
Las bravas.
Hola, teacher.
Ok, good. Clarisa Yamilet. Clarisa Yamilet Chacón. Ok, Rodrigo Alexander Maravilla.
Presente, teacher.
Really good, Rodrigo. Daisy Elizabeth Recinos. Daisy? No, Daisy is not here. Okay. Tatiana Yvonne Torres.
I am here, teacher.
Okay, really good, Tatiana. Marvin Ernesto Alfaro Campos.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Really good. Carlos René Herrera.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, really nice. Fabricio Alexander Jiménez.
I hear, teacher.
Okay, really good. Okay, vamos a pasar lista nuevamente al finalizar la clase. Así que, please pay full attention to that. Okay, we're going to continue with these students. Basically, we're working on shipping label, right? Estamos trabajando en una etiquetas de envío. Lo básico que lleva es de quién va dirigido, hacia quién. From to. Esto aplica si ustedes envían una carta de amor o formal, de lo que sea, right? From to. De para, right? In this case, we're going to add tracking number. En este caso, agregamos un número de rastreo que sirve para chequear nuestro paquete por dónde viene o si ya va cerca. Muy bien. Then we're going to have quantity, la cantidad del producto que va inside. Shipment, el envío, el número de envío. Sender, una clave a quién se envía. y the date, right? La fecha que se envió. Ok, that's really, really easy. Esto es lo más fácil, así que vamos a pasar to the next activity, right? At the beginning of the class, as I said, we're gonna make a feedback or a review about the four topics. Vamos a hacer un repaso o un review de todos los temas, pero un poquito diferente ya con la práctica, right? Así que esta clase vamos a intentar hacerla lo más interactiva que se pueda. Así que please pay attention to this. Okay, we're gonna start with countable and uncountable nouns, right? ¿Cuáles son los contables y los no contables? Los contables, obviously, the things that you can count. Las cosas que usted sí puede contar, los nombres. Uncountable, los que no puede contar. Ok, vamos a categorizar con una U los que son uncountable. Vamos a categorizar con una C los que sí se pueden contar, right? Ok, así que tenemos chocolate. ¿Se puede contar? No, right? Ok, apple.
Muchas
gracias.
Yes.
Yeah, sure. Good. What about this one? Cheese.
Uncountable.
Uncountable. Very good. Car.
Countable.
Countable. Very good. Hasta acá ya les ayudé, chicos. Así que de aquí hacia abajo es your turn, right? Okay, Carlos. Vamos, Carlos Alfonso.
Sugar. Uncountable.
Uncountable, really good. Thank you. Carlos Enrique, continue. Okay, Carlos Enrique Martinez, are you there?
Uncountable.
Uncountable, really good. Thank you. Okay, Jaime Ernesto Hernandez.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Contable.
Okay, okay. Jaime, ¿cómo se dice esto?
Un contable.
Un contable, yes.
Es oil, es combustibles, oil.
Yeah, yeah, it's something like that. Más o menos, más o menos. Aceite.
Aceite, sí, ¿cómo?
Aceite, yeah, really good. Pero es un contable, muy bien, Jaime. Yeah, really good. Marvin.
Butter is unaccountable.
Accountable, really good. Let me see, Fabricio.
Umbrella.
Yep.
Countable.
Countable, really good. Jorge.
Money is uncountable.
Uncountable, right? Uncountable. Yeah, really
uncountable.
Yes, thank you, Jorge. Este es a kind of confused porque el money nosotros lo contamos, right? Pero es difícil saber qué tanto dinero anda cada persona. Y casi siempre cuando hacemos referencia al dinero es de lo que tiene cada persona en su bolsillo o en el banco. Así que no sabemos how much money do they have. Right? Okay, then we're gonna have water. Water. Okay, let me see, Tatiana.
Uncountable.
Uncountable, really good. This one? Gabriela?
Countable.
Okay, countable. Countable?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Los amigos son contados, right? That's right. Eso sí es cierto. Okay, yeah, countable. Creo que ahí estamos de acuerdo todos, right? Okay, what about this one, Rodrigo?
Countable.
Okay, countable, really good. Marlon Ernesto.
Countable, teacher, chew.
Okay, yes, chew, countable. Really good. Carlos René.
Countable.
Countable.
Chicken.
Yeah. It could be both. Debe ser ambos, right? Estamos hablando del chicken ahí vivo, sí, es countable. Estamos hablando de las piezas de carne, es uncountable. hasta que le ponemos a una unidad de medida. Yes? Okay.
Good. Great teacher.
Okay, nice. Okay, let me see, Wendy.
Time is accountable.
Accountable, really good. Thank you, Marlon Ernesto. Okay, Marlon is eating pupusa, right? Okay, that's good. Let me see, cup, it could be countable, right? Una taza o una, un recipiente ahí para tomar agua, si es contable, right? Okay, and the last one that we have is Tatiana.
Jam,
really good. Yes, incontable, really good. La jalea es incontable, a menos que categoricemos básicamente una unidad de medida, right? Okay, really good. Okay, very nice work. Basically, we were talking about countable and uncountable nouns. ¿Se comprende cómo utilizar los nombres contables y los no contables?
Yes.
Yes, really good.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, very good. I hope this topic will be clear, like water, right? Like water. Okay. Let me see. Yeah, sure. Okay, now we're gonna practice, students, something related to the same. But in this case, we're gonna use how much and how many. ¿Con quién vamos a utilizar how much?
Uncountable.
Uncountable. Really nice. Okay, good. And what we're gonna do here? We got a short dialogue between Dad and Trevor. Tenemos un diálogo antes entre papá y esta persona. Así que vamos a ir ubicando en cada pregunta esta expresión correcta. Si es how much, estamos hablando de que no se puede contar. Y si es how many, que sí se puede contar. Muy bien. You're going to have 1 minute to analyze all of these sentences, right? 1 minute. Then we're going to ask randomly. Luego voy a preguntar al azar cuál encaja en cada uno. 1 minute. Ya les quedan 40 segundos. Ok, go ahead.
¿Es por qué trabaja en la oficina de la alcaldesa? ¿No te podría estudiar mejor al enemigo que su mismo campo? ¿Sabía que la alcaldesa recibe su consultor? Por supuesto. ¿Quién cree que puso Marte en eso? Usted le dijo. ¿Por qué no se muera a la alcaldesa usted mismo? Pasarlo como ya está.
Okay, ready, right? Okay, basically, students, you have to pay full attention to the nouns before how much or how many, right? For example, onion, cheese, tomatoes, spaghetti, meat. Cada uno de esos nos va a ir diciendo si es contable o no contable. Yeah, we're gonna start with that. Who wants to try it? ¿Quiere intentarlo? I a volunteer.
Okay, Trevor.
Uh-huh.
How many onions do we need?
Yeah, very good, Tatiana. Congratulations. Okay, how many, right? Because onions, you think how? Really good. Okay. Okay, nice. ¿Qué dice Trevor? Ahí, Rodrigo. Read it, please.
Just one onion, I think.
Okay, very good. Do we need just one onion, right? Thank you, Rodrigo. Really good. Okay, Rodrigo, para aprovechar ahí, can you choose the best option for this?
Very good. And how much cheese?
Okay, very good. How much cheese? Nice. Thank you. Okay, Gabriela?
About 100 grams.
The next, también.
Okay, okay, yeah, yeah, this one.
Okay, 100 grams, fine, now.
Oi.
How many tomatoes, Trevor?
Okay, very good, thank you, Gabriela. How many, right? Thank you so much. Okay, very good. Then we're gonna have how many tomatoes, right? Gabriela said, and we need 10 tomatoes, right? 10 tomatoes, really good. Okay, continue with this one, Marvin.
What about spaghetti?
Yeah.
And how, how much spaghetti do we need?
Yeah, really good. Thank you, Marvin. How much, right? ¿Por qué how much and not how many?
It's uncountable.
Yeah, it's uncountable. Yeah, really good. Son demasiados, no los vamos a poder contar. Véndame dos trocitos de espagueti. No, right? Ahí, a bunch of spaghetti. It's really good. Okay, thank you, Marvin. Fabricio, read this.
We don't need to buy any. We have some at home.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Espaguetis, no necesitamos comprar nada porque ya hay en casa.
¿Qué tenemos en la casa?
Yeah, really good. Ya hay the government package, right? Okay, okay, very good. Let me see. Jaime Ernesto, try to do this one. Okay, Jaime Ernesto, turn on the microphone, encienda el micrófono.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Right? Oh, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. Don't write the last, last three is me.
Yeah.
Is me. How many? How much?
How much
meat do need?
Do we need really good work. How much? En este caso, meat significa carne, right? Pero no sabemos qué cantidad quiere. En este caso, son es importante. Muchos. Así que meat, oh, 500 grams, right? That's 500 grams beef. Okay, yeah. Very good.
Yes.
¿Se comprende esto? Or do you have a question so far?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, really good. Wow. Nice. Jaime Ernesto, questions? No questions?
Yeah. No question.
Okay, okay, really good. Nice. Okay, how much? Para lo que no se pueden contar. How many? Para lo que sí se pueden contar.
Yeah.
Okay, muy bien. Okay, let's continue with this. And now we're gonna practice our listening skill, right? ¿Se recuerdan que el día de ayer pusimos un audio y no nos funcionó? Then I said that we're gonna put again, right? Pusimos otro, así que nos hizo falta uno. Okay. Let's see. Pongamos full attention to this, right? We're gonna listen to an audio. Okay, yeah, I have it here and here, yeah. Okay, students, basically we're gonna listen to a native speaker, right? Vamos a escuchar hablantes nativos americanos. Suena un poco diferente a nosotros, así que ponga mucha atención.
Vamos a escuchar,
yeah. Okay, here we go.
Hi, young lady. How may I help you?
Well, yeah, I'm looking for a father.
¿Se escucha?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Silencio todos los micrófonos.
Okay, yeah. Okay. All my.
Las llaves.
Okay. Okay. Very good. Yeah. Here we go again. Ahí va.
Hi, young lady. How may I help you?
Well, yeah, I'm looking for a Father's Day gift.
Okay, how about getting your father a new wallet?
How much is that wallet?
Which one?
The black one.
Oh, it's only $40.95.
Huh? That's too expensive for me. Do you have a cheaper one?
How about this brown leather one?
I don't think my father would like the design on the outside. And it doesn't have a place to put pictures. How much is it anyway?
It's $25.99.
I don't have that much money.
Okay, how much money do you have to spend?
I'm not sure. Probably about $10 or so. I've been helping my mom around the house for the past week to earn some money. This is all I have.
How about this tie?
That's real pretty, but the price tag says $13.99, and I know I don't have that much money.
Well, let's just say the tie went on sale. How about $5? What do you say?
Oh, thanks. I'll take it.
Okay, very good. You got it right. Okay, the conversation was between a man that sell stuff and a little lady, right? Probably a 4 years old lady. Así que, ¿de qué se habló ahí en la conversation? Más o menos lo que entendieron. Don't worry.
Que la niña, bueno, yo como que una niña escuché que iba a comprar un regalo para el papá y que tenía que comprar una cartera. Y el vendedor le dijo que la cartera costaba, no escuché bien la cantidad, pero que fue muy cara para la niña y que pidió una más barata.
Ok, very good, nice. Buen oído, Jorge, Alberto, muy bien, really good. Todo lo que él dijo es correcto, estaba hablando de un regalo para su papá. Una cartera en específico. Y no compró su cartera por una razón en específica, que ya la vamos a ver. Así que al final vamos a ir respondiendo cada una de esas preguntas. ¿Cuánto gastó la niña? Y al final, ¿qué decidió comprarle al papá? Según todas las moneditas que se escucharon al final. ¿Les parece si lo escuchamos nuevamente y try to understand in a better way this? Okay, here we go.
Hi, young lady. How may I help you?
Well, I'm looking for a Father's Day gift.
Okay, how about getting your father a new wallet?
How much is that wallet?
Which one?
The black one.
Oh, it's only $40.95.
Huh? That's too expensive for me. Do you have a cheaper one?
How about this brown leather one?
I don't think my father would like the design on the outside. And it doesn't have a place to put pictures. How much is it anyway?
It's $25.99.
I don't have that much money.
Okay, how much money do you have to spend?
I'm not sure. Probably about $10 or so. I've been helping my mom around the house for the past week to earn some money. This is all I have.
How about this tie?
That's real pretty, but the price tag says $13.99, and I know I don't have that much money.
Well, let's just say the tie went on sale. How about $5? What do you say?
Oh, thanks. I'll take it.
Okay, really good. Ahora sí se entendió. Clarísimo, right? Really clear. Okay, students. We're going to try to answer this question from this conversation, right? And we got the first one. It says, what is the girl shopping for? ¿Para quién andaba comprando esta chiquilla?
A present for her father.
Okay, yeah, really good. A present for her father, really good. Nice, good job. Okay. What about this one? How much is the black wallet? ¿Cuánto valía la cartera?
49
Okay, now we're gonna see this. Let me see this one. Why does the girl like the brown wallet? ¿Por qué a la niña no le gustó la cartera café?
There is not a place to put a picture.
Yeah, thank you, Wendy. Really good. Reason, right? Yeah, congratulations. Good job. Entre todos se hace muy fácil este test. We're going to continue with this. How much does the girl how to spend? Más o menos alrededor de cuánto quiere gastar la niña.
$10.
Everybody's agree?
Ten.
Yeah.
Ten.
Okay. Are you sure? Okay, here we go. Yeah, very good. Good work. Okay, veamos acá. Okay, here we go. The last one. What does the girl decide to buy? ¿Qué, al final, qué decidió comprar la niña?
A tie.
Tie. Yep. Sure. Really good. A tie. Yeah, congratulations. Amazing. Really good work. Okay, students. Realmente estos audios son bastante importantes porque nosotros vemos a qué nos enfrentamos en la realidad. Nos quedamos, wow, teacher, but native speakers speak really quickly. Sometimes I don't understand what they say, right? A veces no entendemos qué dicen. Pero recuérdense que la práctica nos va a ayudar a entender eso. Todo es entrenar el oído y manejar muy bien la información que ustedes ya tienen. Yep. Okay, very good. We're going to continue with today's class because, it's really, really interesting, right? And now we're going to go with have to for obligations. Have to. Have, el solito significa tengo. For example, I have a dog, I have a cat, tengo un chuchito, tengo un gatito, whatever, right? Pero si ustedes le agregan to, se hace una obligación. How come? ¿Cómo así? Ya no se convertiría en solo tengo una posesión de algo. Tengo un carro, tengo una bici, lo que sea. En este caso ya se convierte en una obligación. Yo tengo que limpiar esa bicicleta. Yo tengo que darle de comer a ese gatito. Ya sería una obligation, right? Entonces, tener que, have to. Keep in mind, please. Okay, really good. ¿Qué vamos a hacer? Tenemos several examples of this. Tenemos muchos ejemplos y posibles respuestas. Podemos utilizar have to, has to, o solo have. Ustedes deciden. ¿Cuándo vamos a utilizar has to?
Terceras personas.
Yeah, really good. Okay, como veo que ustedes son really, really expert on this, we're gonna start with this activity, right? Okay, Wendy Bonilla, ready?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, really good. You're born ready. Nací lista. Okay, muy bien, vamos. Number one.
I have to get up very early every morning at 6 o'clock.
Okay, really good, Wendy. I have to write letter A.
Yes.
Yeah, cool, congratulations. ¿Y es cierto esta oración, Wendy? Yes or not?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, really good. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna go with question number two, right? And let me see, Marlon Ernesto.
John and Cindy has to go to work every day.
Okay, okay, Marlon, letter A, B or C?
Sí.
Sí, sí.
Sí.
Okay, okay. Entonces, John and Cindy have to, right? Have to.
John and Cindy have to work every day.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Really good work. Letter C, right? Okay, I'm gonna continue with number three. Let me see. ¿Quién tiene carita que quiere participar? Okay, Carlos Enrique. Carlos Enrique. Okay, number three.
We have to study for our next grammar test.
Okay, really good. Letter A, B, or C, Carlos?
Letter B.
Letter B? Yeah, really good. Congratulations. Amazing. Okay, now, let me see. Ya entramos a otro nivel un poquito más complicado. Aquí vamos a agregar un auxiliary, right? Gabriela, can you help us? ¿Nos puede ayudar? Number four.
Number four. Does your brother have to go to a job interview tomorrow?
Yeah, really good. Letter A, B, or C?
C.
C. Thank you, Gabriela. Amazing. Really good work. Okay, I'm gonna jump with number nine. Jaime Ernesto, ¿me puede ayudar? Okay, Jaime, can you turn on the microphone?
otra vez. Okay, ahí está.
Okay, no, no hay problema. Yo le entiendo ahí through your lips, but
yes.
The rest of the class need to listen to you. Go ahead.
In glad, quickly, in plural. Sí, have two degrees.
Okay, letter?
How to drill in the lips sounds of the road.
Of the road.
The road.
Road, really good. Thank you, Jaime. Really good work. Okay, Jaime, it's letter A, right?
A.
A.
They have,
yeah,
have
A.
To dry.
Right, dry. Yes.
Yeah.
Really good. Thank you, Jaime. Eso es lo bueno de intentarlo. No se preocupe, aquí estamos para equivocarnos y aprender. ¿Por qué no sería letter C? Porque el verbo lleva S. Y cuando lleva una S, vamos a utilizarlo con terceras personas. ¿Cuáles son las terceras personas? Ella, él y cosa. En inglés sería she, he, and it. Right? Okay, very good. Thank you. Number 10. Carlos Alfonso.
I have to take my car into the garage.
Yep.
To get it fixed.
Okay, to get it fixed. Yes. Okay, thank you, Carlos. Letter C, right?
C.
Yeah. Okay, very good. Thank you. And number 11. Okay, let me see. Daisy Recinos, can you help us, Daisy?
Hello.
Hello, Daisy. Can you help me with number 11, please?
Okay, 11. Why children go to the school?
Okay, really good. What option is the best for you? A, B, or C?
A.
A, are you sure? Children? Singular or plural? Este es plural.
Okay, why children go to the school? Why can they stay at home?
Okay.
C.
Letter B or C?
C.
C. Okay, really good. Okay, Daisy, is letter what? B.
Oh my God, B. Sorry.
Yeah, no, don't worry, right?
What?
Why? Veamos por qué. Acá decimos why, por qué los niños tienen que ir a la escuela. En este caso, tenemos este verbo que se usa para obligación y no es a futuro con going to. Si utilizamos are, tendría que ir a futuro con going to o con ing. Por lo tanto, no puede ir are, sino solo do, porque do es un auxiliar. Solo nos va a indicar que es una question, right?
Okay, thank you, teacher. Okay, excellent.
Very good. Okay, we're gonna continue with the last one. Let me see. Okay. Okay. Let me see. Okay, let me get Carlos Mejía. Carlos. Okay, the last one. Vamos a darle la bienvenida ahí.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, good evening. This one.
What do you answer?
Okay, okay, Carlos, can you speak aloud, please? Puede hablarnos un poquito más fuerte ahí, casi no lo escuchamos.
Ah, okay, teacher. What do you do after our class, business or club? B.
Okay, are you sure? It happened the same. Pasa lo mismo que acá.
I'm sorry. Sería C.
C, right? Yeah. Can you read it using this?
What do you have to do after our class business at 3 o'clock?
Yeah, congratulations, Carlos. Really good work. Nice. Okay, students, basically, in that way, you're going to use have to for obligation. De esa manera, van a utilizar have to para una obligación. For example, I'm going to give you a couple of examples of this. In my personal case, right, I have to get up early. Then I have to cook my lunch, I mean my breakfast. And after that, I have to clean my house. And that's amazing, right? Okay, very good. That's my obligation. Okay, really good. Okay, now we're gonna go. Toda esta clase va a ser de práctica, así que I'm sorry for that. Pero hay que practicar. Así que now we're going to jump out to can for information and possibility. What does it mean, can?
Poder.
Yeah. Poder, de poder hacer algo. Vamos a utilizar poder para dar información o una posibilidad.
Posibilidad.
Muy bien. ¿Cómo así? For example, if I say, let me see. I can work in the afternoon. Yo puedo trabajar en la tarde. Puede ser una información o una posibilidad, right? Both. Okay, very good. Veamos algunos ejemplos acá. Let's see. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, I need somebody who help me to read the first example. En este caso, me va a leerlo y luego me lo va a traducir into Spanish, right? Okay, the first one. El primero siempre es el más fácil, así que ahí. Okay. Okay, Marlon, ready?
Lauren can't go to the party because she doesn't have a new dress.
Okay, what's happened with Lauren?
Lorena no podrá ir a la fiesta porque ella tiene una nueva dirección.
Okay, porque ella
no tiene una nueva dirección. Nuevo vestido.
Vestido. Really good. Okay, le hago el ejemplo acá, pero es yo no es vestido, right? Más o menos, you got it, really good. Okay, continue with the second one. Marvin, go ahead.
Camille can't sleep because She has a headache.
Headache.
Dice que Camila no puede dormir porque a ella le duele la cabeza.
Yeah, really good. That's happened, right? All the time. Eso pasa todo el tiempo. Okay, very good. Number three, who wants to try it? Number three, you can do it. Don't worry. Okay, go ahead, Wendy.
Espérame, aquí voy.
Okay.
Si me ve. Ahí. Bien. Arnold can watch TV this afternoon because he took the day off. Arnold mira la televisión en la tarde porque él ahí sí talk. I don't remember.
He took.
Como que tomó una siesta.
Él tomó
día libre. El día libre.
Yeah, really good.
Gracias. Thank you.
Como usted, ¿verdad? The day off.
No.
Are you working right now? Wendy's
no.
Okay. Thank you, Wendy. Okay, we're going to continue with this. Who wants to do it?
Emily can cross the street to help.
Okay, without.
Without. Thank you. Emily no puede cruzar la calle sin ayuda.
Okay, very good, Tatiana. Good work. Without student significa sin. For example, without sugar, without salt, lo que sea, no quieren que lleve algo, sin. En este caso, nos dice Tatiana que Emily no puede cruzar la calle sin ayuda, because probably she's blind, right? Okay, really good. Okay, we're gonna jump to number five. Who wants to do it? Go ahead, gentlemen, you can do it, ladies. Don't be shy. Okay, go ahead.
Alice can spend the day on the beach because she's on vacation.
Okay,
dice, Alice puede pasar el tiempo o puede pasar el día en la playa porque ella está de vacaciones.
Okay, really good, Fabricio. Thank you. Nice.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to jump to number six. Okay, who wants to do it? ¿Quiere intentarlo antes que se terminen ahí?
Teacher.
Carol.
Okay,
Carol and her father can play until
midnight
today because tomorrow is Sunday.
Yeah, really good.
Carol y su padre pueden jugar toda la noche
hasta
medianoche.
Yeah.
Hasta medianoche porque mañana es domingo.
Yeah, really good. Es como el día de ahora que Friday knows, right? No lo sabía, así que no se querían conectar. Okay, pretty. Okay, nice. Okay, I'm going to jump to number, let me see.
Yep.
Okay, go ahead. Thank you.
The Millers can sit and talk because their grandson is at school. Los Millers pueden sentarse y platicar porque sus nietos están en la escuela.
Ok, very nice. Un gran descanso, right? Cuando los niños van a la escuela. Por el momento, los papás y las mamás están sufriendo, I think. Ok, pero ni modo, right? Ok, we're going to jump to the last one. Thank you, Gabriela. Nice
promotion. Meet the chair.
Ok, go ahead, Carlos.
Angela can get new shoes because she got a new job. Angela puede tener nuevos zapatos porque ella tiene un nuevo trabajo.
Really, really good word. Thank you, Carlos. Básicamente, that's happened, right? When we get a new job, we want to buy new things, probably a bicycle, a new motorcycle, a new car, a new cat, and a lot of things, right? Really good. Okay, students, basically, as you see, we can use can for information and possibility, right? Podemos utilizar can para dar información o posibilidad. Ambos son la forma para las que se usa. I don't know if you have a question about this. Questions? No questions? No, right? Okay. Okay, very good. We're gonna finish with this, right? Then you're gonna practice a lot of things today. Okay, vamos a ir finalizando con esto. Así que aquí tenemos un board game, un pequeño jueguito. Lo vamos a modificar because of the time. En cada uno de estos números tiene una questions que ustedes tienen que contestar. Así que please try to understand and give an answer, right? Son preguntas fáciles de lo que ustedes tienen que hacer. Recuérdense que be going to es voy a, future time, voy a hacer. Teníamos un pequeño dilema ahí con Jorge, que will y be going to es lo mismo, solo que will es una cosa, cuestión rápida, y be going to es algo que usted va a hacer. Ok, muy bien. En este caso solo vamos a utilizar be going to en cada una de estas. Así que, please, Tatiana, can you give me a number from 1 to 10? Deme un número del 1 al 10. Ok, Tatiana. Can you turn on the microphone, please? Okay. What number?
No sé.
From 1 to 10, cualquiera que esté aquí, solo dígame un número. 1, 2, 6. 6, really good. This one, right? Okay, Tatiana, number 6. Vamos a sugerírsela ahí a Fabricio. Fabricio, this is the question for you. Ready?
Okay.
Okay, Fabricio, yo te la voy a preguntar y tú me tienes que contestarla, right? What are you going to do today?
I am going to cook the dinner.
Oh, really? Okay, nice. Okay, really good, Fabricio.
Okay, teacher.
Congratulations. That's amazing. Tienen que ayudar ahí a las wives to cook the dinner, right? Really good. Okay, Fabricio, give me a number from 1 to 10.
5.
Uh-huh. I'm sorry?
5.
5, 5. Okay, really good.
5, 5, 5.
Thank you. Okay, let me see number 5. Let me see. Okay, Marlon Ernesto, number 5. Okay, ready?
Okay. Okay, teacher.
Okay, Marlon, are you going to visit your grandmother at the weekend?
Yes. Yes, I'm going to visit my mother.
My grandmother. Yeah, really good. Really good. Nice. Congratulations, Marlon. Really good work. Okay, Marlon, give me a number from 1 to 10.
10.
10. Really good. Okay. Okay, really good. Esta pregunta se la vamos a hacer a Gabriela. Gabriela, number 10. Ready? Are you going to bed early today?
Please. Okay, pues sí.
Okay.
No, I am not going to bed early today.
Okay, really good, Gabriela. But you have to. You have to. You need to sleep, right? Okay, thank you, Gabriela. Give me a number from 1 to 5.
Number 3.
Three. Very good. This is the last one. Esta es la última. Let me see. Yeah. Okay. Vamos a ver. Rodrigo. Rodrigo. This is the question for you. Is your mother, Rodrigo, going to buy new clothes next week?
I don't know. But I'm going to buy new shoes the next week.
Okay, very good. Nice. Thank you, Rodrigo. Really good work. Okay, students, that was the game. Ese era el juego que traíamos. Así que we're going to continue. No las podemos hacer todas por el tiempo. Ya nos avanzó mucho y tenemos que practicar together, right, as we do all the classes. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is to practice the previous knowledge in group, right? Okay, how come? ¿Qué vamos a hacer? Ahora sí, vamos a unir todo lo que hemos hecho esta semana. Veamos. You have to write a sentence with have to, can, and going to. Al menos tienes que hacer dos por cada una de ellas. Dos con have to, dos con can, dos con going to, right? Luego, van a preguntarse estas tres questions. What do you have to do? What do you have to do? ¿Qué tienen que hacer? Por ejemplo, si alguien me dice, teacher, what do you have to do? Yo le voy a decir, ah, okay, I have to clean my house, and I have to feed my dog. Y tengo que alimentar al Firulai ahí. Muy bien. The second, what can you do at your workplace? Todas estas, si ustedes notan, ya las hicimos. ¿Qué puedes hacer en tu lugar de trabajo? Y ustedes dicen, I can do this, I can do that, right? And the last one, what are you going to do at your workplace? ¿Qué vas a hacer en tu lugar de trabajo? Mire, teacher, I'm going to play basketball. I'm going to play soccer, porque a veces los trabajos son tan geniales que es de jugar fútbol, basketball, and so on, right? Pero no es nuestro caso, I think. Así que vamos a decir lo que nosotros vamos a hacer. Por favor, agregar greetings and opening questions. ¿Cómo así? ¿Qué es greetings? Ajá, greetings.
Saludos.
Saludos y preguntas de apertura. Por ejemplo, antes de que ustedes se pregunten todo esto, van a decir, hey, hello, how are you, Fabricio? Y vamos a comenzar a decirle las preguntas. Que se escuche como...
Good morning.
Yeah. Y luego, chicos, tienen que utilizar un farewell. ¿Qué es un farewell? Un farewell. Hey.
Como despedirse.
Yeah, una despedida. Okay, thank you. Bye. See you later. Y ahí finalizamos la pequeña conversación. ¿Se comprendió? It's clear? Yep. Okay, it's clear like or chat, I think. Okay. ¿Se comprende, right? Yeah. Sure. Okay, we're going to work in groups. Vamos a trabajar en grupos, así que las preguntas, espero que hayan tomado nota. Si no tomaron notas, voy a escribirla en el chat. Don't worry. Okay, we're going to make group for this. Okay, let me see how many 15. Okay, 3, 4, 5. Okay, here we go, students. Bye-bye. Try to practice each other, help with your partner, and be kind, use greetings, use the opening questions, try to be kind, and please don't be shy. You can do it. Go ahead. Okay. Acepten ahí la invitación para sus grupos respectivos, right? Okay, Daisy, are you there? Ah, yeah, go ahead. Okay. Hello, how are you?
Hello, teacher.
Hello, teacher. How are you?
I'm fine. ¿Cómo vamos, Bray?
Aquí haciendo la respuesta.
Okay, very good. I don't know if you have a question. No questions?
No question, no. Teacher.
Okay, very good. Continue working, and when you're ready, practice each other, right?
Vamos okay, teacher.
Visit another group. Thank you.
No sé, I'm going to make a memorandum.
Yes.
Y después ya solo nos despedimos como, okay, see you soon o algo así.
Okay. ¿Tenemos que anotar esto, Rodrigo, o lo...?
Sí, si le es más fácil anotarlo y después... Como vamos a ir en un orden, puede irlo leyendo también, para que no...
Ok. Entonces vamos a anotar cuántas, Rodrigo.
Dos de have two,
¿verdad?
Dos have two, cosas que tiene que hacer. Después sería mi pregunta, what do you have to do? Y la siguiente, what can you do at the workplace? Yeah. Ah, perdón, ahí era... Cosas que puedes hacer, por ejemplo, I can take 5 minutes to in like a break. Okay. Puedo tomar. Sí.
And watch TV. Ajá. Bueno, de ahí sería otra vez Fabricio, vea. Usted me haría, pero no entendí. Espéreme. La última dijo que teníamos que agregar el saludo.
La primera era el saludo. De ahí es un how are you. Ahí estaba ahí también un how are you. Es como una conversación, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh.
What's your name? Pero ese what's your name no pega porque como ya le dije hi.
Cabal.
Ya tenía que saludar. Hi. Good evening. What's your name?
Ajá. Ah, no, pero aquí en la respuesta, cuando usted me dice hello, what do you do? Yo le digo hello, Fabricio. I have a cooking diner and watch TV.
Ajá.
Y de ahí otra vez usted, Fabricio, me dice, ahí usted me puede preguntar cómo estoy, no sé, ¿qué es la otra que pega?
Okay.
No, el teacher está oyendo. No
sí, está.
I'll be back in a minute. Regreso a mi instante.
Anda de espía.
Yeah. Okay, a really nice song. Este tiene cancioncita así de fondo, right? Okay, very good. Okay, I don't know if you have a question about this.
Not teacher.
Not teacher.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Okay, continue working.
Thank you.
To another group.
Okay.
Okay, hello guys.
Hello teacher.
How is everything? ¿Cómo está todo por ahí?
Estamos armando, teacher, ahorita.
Okay, okay, very good. We continue working on this. I don't know if you have a question about this activity. No questions?
No, teacher.
Okay, very nice. Okay, guys, continue working. I'm gonna go to another group. Vamos a ir a otro grupo, así que bye bye, regreso en un instante.
Okay, teacher.
Okay.
Ya, ya está lista.
Sí.
Okay. Okay, le quiere estar if you want.
Las damas primero, dice.
Hello, Carlos. Ah, no. Tengo que preguntarle el nombre, ¿verdad? Hello, what's your name?
My name is Carlos. How are you?
Fine. How are you doing?
I'm fine too. And then, what do you have to do?
Perdón. ¿Qué? ¿Cómo? What?
What do you have to do?
I have to get up early. I have to send email.
Okay. Hey, what can you do at your workplace? What can you do at your workplace?
I can breakfast in office. I can drink water at any time.
Okay. What are you going to do at your work?
I'm going to drink very water. I'm going to check my email.
Okay, excellent.
I see nice you later.
Nice to see you. Take care.
Okay, very nice. Good work. Okay, students, as you see, right now you're going to be able to interact each other, right?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, very good. Lo hicieron muy bien, excelente, muy buen trabajo. Continúen practicando, en este caso Tatiana le pregunta a Carlos. Voy a ir a otro grupo, los escuché, suficiente, muy bien, muy buen trabajo. So, really good.
Okay. Okay. Go ahead, Tatiana. Let's continue.
Paulita se cayó en los audífonos.
Hi.
Bye.
Going to I'm going to ¿Qué es lo que hace en su trabajo?
Supervise.
¿Qué más?
Supervise, revisar. Conducir.
I'm going to drive.
Drive.
And super. Teacher, así se escribe supervisar como verbo.
Okay, supervise. Supervise. Yeah, sure. Like this.
My partners. Partners. ¿Está bien esa oración?
Yeah. I'm gonna try and supervise my partner. Okay, in this case, Rodrigo, solo vamos a poner, como tenemos dos verbos y lo dividimos con N, vamos a poner esto con ING. I'm gonna drive
supervise
my partner. Pero está muy bien. Yeah.
Okay. Vaya, Jaime. Entonces, esta es toda la conversación que vamos a tener.
Ok.
Si quieres, practicamos.
Yes.
Daisy. No sé si está Daisy ahí.
Daisy, are you there?
Hola. Sí, aquí estoy escuchando. Este, no estoy participando porque aún estoy como con dolor en la garganta, entonces estoy solamente.
Just listen, right?
Okay.
Okay, okay, don't worry. Go ahead. Rodrigo and Jaime gonna teach you cómo hacer la conversation, right?
Okay.
Muy bien, go ahead.
Okay, Jaime, entonces vamos, nada más hacemos una introducción y después todo lo de acá.
Okay.
Hi, Jaime. How is it going?
I'm fine.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Yoveda, I'm having to get early tomorrow.
Yeah.
I have to my work.
Yeah.
Okay. What do you have to do?
I have to make reports.
Okay,
what can you do at your workplace?
I am checking my phone and dry coffee.
Okay, what are you going to do at your workplace?
I am going to dry and supervise my personnel.
Okay. Bueno, entonces, Jaime, si quiere ahora, no lo habíamos hecho, pero todo lo que dice mi nombre, me lo puede preguntar a mí.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, perdón, le voy a decir esto primero.
Sí,
I have to.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I have to eat early every day. And I have to drink a lot of water because it's healthy.
What do you have to do?
I have to go to my work because everybody needs money.
What can you do at your work? Well, please.
I can fix my car or my motorcycle, and I can help some friends.
What are you going to do at your workplace?
For example, tomorrow I'm going to finish a car because I was fixing the engine, and then I'm going to go to grandmother's house because we have the her birthday.
Okay, perfect. Yes.
Okay, that's it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, really good. Congratulations, students. Really, really nice. We got a budget there. Okay. Okay, thank you, Rodrigo and Jaime Ernesto. Thank you, Daisy Recinos. Sé que pues es difícil estar with a health problem, but she's there. Así que, guys, if you want to continue practice, you can do it. I'm going to go to another group. Congratulations. Really good work.
Okay. Thank you. Sorry.
Okay. No problem. Bye. See you in a moment.
You're going to teach.
Hello, teacher.
How are you?
How are you, teacher?
I'm fine. Are you?
I'm fine.
Listen the conversation, el teacher.
Is
this Pia?
Did you practice?
Ahorita.
Okay.
Estábamos esperando que terminara Carlos.
But now you're.
Ya, Carlos.
Ah, ya sí. Ya.
Bye. Okay. Entonces, ¿quién pregunta primero? Carlos, si quiere empiece usted. Pues sí. Ya que lo oigo tímido.
Ah.
Okay.
Wendy.
¿Qué te pasó? Casi no lo escucho.
Hi, how are you, Wendy?
I'm fine, thank you.
What did you have to do?
I have a cook, a diner, and watch TV.
What kind of at your workplace?
I have a conversation with different persons, also test different products the bread.
What are you going to do at your workplace?
I have a different customer and a different customer and conversations, the project.
Okay.
Interesting. Nice to greet you, Frank.
Okay, really good.
Más o menos.
No, really good. Vamos bien, porque veo que ya manejan la información así, genial. Okay.
Fabricio, pregunte usted a Carlos.
Ah, bueno.
Pues sí.
Hi, good evening. How are you?
Ah, ¿cómo está? Me dijo, ¿verdad? Perdón.
Yes, yes.
Ajá, yes.
Very good.
Okay. What's your name?
My name is Pablo.
Okay. What do you have to do?
I have to go shopping. I have to wash my pet.
Okay. Later, what can you do at your workplace? What can you do at your workplace?
I can answer the phone and make my daily report. I can help my coworker and them.
Okay. What are you going to do on your workplace?
I'm going to finish and read the file. I'm going to meet with my partner.
Okay, very good. Bye, man.
A usted le vamos a preguntar.
Okay.
Very nice. Antes que ataquen a Fabrizio, congratulations, you did it really, really good. Me gusta que se suelten, que sea natural. A medida va pasando el tiempo, vamos a ir puliendo, como lo dice Marat, todo eso, right? Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to continue working with Fabrizio. I'm going to go to another group. Thank you so much.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. Well, hello, Fabrizio.
Ya va a aparecer por ahí, porque ya va a ser hora, creo.
Sí, sí. Ya falta poquito.
Oh.
Ahí viene.
Ah.
Llamando ya.
Okay, how are you?
Fine.
I'm fine.
Okay, did you practice already?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Really?
Fine. I
Okay, can you practice again? I would like to listen to you.
Okay, ¿quién empieza? Marvin, start.
Okay.
Okay. Hi, Gabriela. My name is Marvin.
Nice to meet you, Marvin. My name is Merari.
Nice to meet you. How are you?
I'm fine. And you?
I'm fine. What do you have to do?
I have to work from Monday to Friday, and I have to cook every day.
Oh, and what you can do your workplace?
I can do checks to pay the bills, but I cannot sign them.
Interesante. And what are you going to do at your workplace?
I'm going to do the payroll, and I'm not going to go to a meeting. And what about you? What do you have to do?
I will feed my pets.
Oh, what can you do at your workplace?
I can service a client and sell our service.
Oh, interesting. What are you going to at your workplace?
I'm going to sign some documents.
Oh, interesting.
So, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. See you.
I see you later.
Okay, very, very nice. Really good work. Okay, right now, please ask to Carlos Alfonso.
Yeah.
Okay.
Carlos,
okay. Igual lo hicimos, igual nos salió.
Ah, okay.
Okay, ¿con quién ahí? ¿Con Merari o con Marvin?
Okay, I don't know, whatever you want.
Conmigo, si quieres.
Okay. Practicado con...
Se me había descargado la compu.
No problem.
La conecté.
Okay, go ahead.
Hi, Merari, how are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Very good, very good.
Okay, excuse me, what do you have to do?
I have to go to the supermarket and visit my parents.
It's nice. What can you do at your workplace?
I can call phone, also visit friends for business.
Oh, what are you going to at your workplace?
Tomorrow going out to the workplace. Only we'll watch TV in the house.
Oh, interesting. So it was a pleasure to talk to you, but I have to go. See you.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, nice to have talk with you.
Okay, very nice. Okay, students, you did it really, really nice. Congratulations. I really like how to introduce yourself and how to ask the questions. And also, you add the farewell in a really good way. Thank you so much. I'm going to jump to the last group, and I'll see you in a minute. Okay.
Okay.
Thanks.
Okay.
¿Cómo se llama el canal de estos lobos?
Hello.
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
Ya practicamos.
Okay, ya practicaron, right? Okay, very good. Because of the time, students, yo sé que ustedes son sumamente smart, así que ya el tiempo ya no nos da para escucharlos, pero congratulations, ustedes hicieron un buen trabajo. I'm gonna check it out, you know. on the. Así que, at the main session, right? Okay, thank you.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, hello, hello, students. I really like this group. Did you practice a lot? I surprised, right? You have, most of you have a really nice
routine.
Yeah, okay, now we don't have enough time, so that's why I'm gonna check the attendance list again. Vamos a pasar lista ahí rapidito para los que no estaban. Y ahora sí ya se incorporaron, así que please, listen to your name. Let's see, vamos a llamar solo los que no están. That's great. Okay, here we go. Please, when you say, when you hear your name, please say presente, right? Jose Vladimir Jimenez Escobar. Are you there, Jose? No, right? Okay, very good. Jose Angel Santos Martinez. Jose Angel Santos Martinez, are you there?
Okay. Ahí estaba, creo que le habló con tuvo en mi grupo.
Yeah, yeah. Ahí está Jose Angel. No, acá está, creo que tiene problemas con el micrófono. Ahí está, Jose Angel. Yeah. Se presente, Jose Angel.
I'm here.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Okay. Okay, okay. Okay, Jose Angel, thank you. Fernando de Jesús Roldán Torres. All right. Okay, okay, very good. Present, right? Okay, here we go. Carlos Antonio Mejía Hernández.
Present.
Really good. William Alexander Martinez Enriquez.
Thank you.
Okay, William. All right. Let me see. Miguel Angel Alexander Lopez Crespin. All right. Okay. Clarissa Yamilet. Recinos.
I'm here.
Daisy Elizabeth Recino Álvarez, I'm sorry, Daisy.
I'm here.
Okay, thank you, Daisy. Right now, we're gonna jump with this. Clarissa Esquerosta, muy bien. Okay, very good. Okay. Okay, students, veamos. Okay. Okay. Everybody finish the homework? Number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No.
No, teacher, I have a problem with this platform.
Okay, okay, veamos, chicos. Intenten hacerla porque necesito cuadrar la nota. Ahora en la noche o mañana en la mañana, más tardar. ¿Sí? Es importante que tengan todas las tareas y he visto que se han comentado en el discussion box, han puesto muy buenos comentarios, algunos me han hecho reír bastante, son muy geniales, cosa que hemos hablado de la clase, así que vamos bien. Los que no lo han hecho, los invito a hacerlo, la plataforma es para ustedes, para que puedan interactuar y si algo no se comprendió de la clase, pueden volver a poner el video y verse. Ahí como estaban de guapos y guapas, right? Okay, very good. Unfortunately, students, time is over. Desafortunadamente, el tiempo se nos pasa, uf, volando. Quisiera que tuviésemos una hora más, pero I know that you have to go to sleep, right? Okay, okay, very good. That's it for today's class. Please work on the homework. Have a good night. Bye bye. Take care.
Good night. Bye bye.
Before bye. Bye bye. Después de las vacaciones, lunes, después de las vacaciones. Yes.
Pregunta.
Yeah, yeah. Dígame.
Quiero ingresar a la plataforma. ¿Cómo le hago ahí? Porque no he podido ingresar a la plataforma. ¿Será que le puedo llamar después? Porque fue el primer día hoy de clase. Okay. ¿Le puedo marcar, teacher?
Ok, Jaime. Ahí recibí un correo.
Sí, el correo. Aquí. Más que todo, Jimmy me envió los links, ¿verdad?
Ok, los links. Entonces, ahí hay un link que dice, si quieren lo voy a compartir acá en la pantalla para los que se quieran quedar.
Ya intenté ingresar.
Ok, veamos acá. Va a aparecer algo así. ¿Esto les aparece?
Ah, sí, claro.
Sí, ¿verdad? Entonces, ustedes van a entrar en aquí, URL del curso. URL. Uh-huh. ¿Sí? Entonces, le damos clic acá y va a cargar una plataforma como esta.
Uh-huh.
Luego, presiona acá donde dice, you are enrolled to begin course. To get course. ¿Sí? Entonces, cliqueamos acá. Ok, y ahí está ya las secciones. Uno, sección 2, 3 y 4. La 1 es la que estamos viendo esta semana, ¿right?
Ok. Son 5 tareas, entonces.
Tareas, muy bien. Tarea 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. En cada una de esas videoconferencias es la clase que ya hemos visto. Vamos a abrir acá. Vamos a abrir en videoconferencia 1. Ustedes abren. Ahí sale el video. Si ustedes ven, quedamos muy hermosos ahí. Así que acá hay un pequeño
foro.
Un foro para discusión. Entonces ustedes le van a agregar y agregan algo del tema, una oración. Por ejemplo, acá Miguel Crespín agregó: How much does it cost? Cell phone, right? How many commands has a PC? Entonces hizo unas preguntas que están muy geniales y cada uno hizo una aportación de acuerdo al tema de ese día. ¿Sí? Aquí está el tema.
Uh-huh. Mm.
Muy bien. Luego de eso, tenemos la tarea number one, tarea uno. Ok, aquí la tarea 1 yo ya la hice.
Puede ser.
Ok, así que homework number 1 es acerca de los nombres contables y los no contables. Ustedes pueden elegir si consideran que es un nombre que no se puede contar de estos tres. Pero un libro, tiempo o un lápiz. Entonces, ¿cuál no se puede contar?
The time.
Ok, very good. Y así van a seguir todo esto. Ok. Luego, en la segunda clase, lo mismo, van a agregar un comentario o una simple oración. Y la tarea 2. Ok, la tarea 2, acá está. Ahí, copiáramos. La tarea 2 es básicamente acerca de lo que vimos en la clase 2. Have to or has to.
Has to.
Entonces aquí tienen unas oraciones acerca de eso. Son cinco. Eso no les va a tomar ni 2 minutos hacer.
Correcto.
Cuando hayan finalizado, le dan submit, right, para que les dé una nota. La ventaja es que pueden volverlo a hacer las veces que quieran hasta que saquen 10 y le dan otra vez acá.
Yo, mi.
Pero sé que al final van a salir bien. Ok, really good. Then we will have homework number 3, right? Tarea número 3, lo mismo, es acerca de Ken. Ken and Ken and Ken, right? Ok. Luego acá, submit and continue. Homework number 4 va a ser de going to, right? Going to. Por ejemplo, ¿qué de esas alternativas encaja acá? Ok, really good. Entonces así van a contestar, right? Y luego tenemos acá, chicos, la tarea, la última, que es de este día, number 5, que esta básicamente solo son definiciones de conceptos que vimos en la primera clase. ¿Sí? Por ejemplo, dice the amount of money required or paid for something. La cantidad de dinero requerida para pagar algo.
The price, quality y stronger price.
Ok, really good. Y ahí ustedes contestan de acuerdo a eso. Son cinco preguntitas nada más. Easy. Mm-hmm. Así que, if you can work on this today, it will be fine.
Ok.
Ahora tengo que subir las notas. Ok.
Mm. Voy a intentar meterme.
Ok. Y a más tardar en la mañana.
Okay. Así
que no olviden, acá en este link, esta información que tienen acá, que ustedes pueden buscar todo relacionado a su curso, right? Pero ustedes tienen que entrar acá. Yes?
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome.
Happy weekend, everyone.
Weekend and go.
Good night.
And
happy summers.
Okay, yeah, really good.
Summer and vacation.
Vacation, really good. Okay, Jaime, more questions?
No puedo ingresar a la plataforma, no sé por qué.
¿Qué le dices, Jaime?
No puedo ingresar a la plataforma y ingresar lo que es el correo.
¿Qué le dices?
El otro.
My vacation.
Jaime, ¿está en el teléfono?
Sí, no puedo ingresar.
Ok, o está en la compu.
Luego en la compu, ok.
Sí, en la compu trabaja mejor porque el teléfono a veces tiene que descargar la aplicación.
Va.
Uh-huh. Muy bien, ok. Así que, that's it for today class. Jaime, write to WhatsApp. Me escribe a WhatsApp ahí en el grupo y me confirma si pudo ingresar. ¿Yes?
¿Cuál es tu WhatsApp, DJ?
Al grupo de WhatsApp está agregado.
Ah, ok.
El grupo.
Okay, yes. Ahí lo busco otra vez, DJ.
Okay, bye-bye. See you next week after vacation, right? Hasta después de la vacación.
Ok.
Bye-bye.
Okay, sí, bye-bye, good night. Semana.
Si ingresan la siguiente semana, solo van a ver una imagen de la beach, the pool, and so on, right? Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
See you.
Happy vacation.
Okay, right.